back to the Big Island
for another edition of Sam Toys in the Kitchen.
Wow. Hey, we're here at Shane Dorian's house. You guys know what Shane Dorian does.
Such a fan.
I know. And Jackson, his son, amazing. And Charlie, the daughter, and Lisa, the wife, here on the Hawaii Island.
And they hunt.
They hunt. Let's go.
Jesus.
Oh, man. Hey, Jackson.
Hey,
give me a hug, bud. Right on.
Hey. Yeah.
Wow,
thanks,
man,
for coming.
Beautiful. Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
Lisa. So hi, how are you?
You too.
Where's Charlie?
She's right here.
Coming, you guys.
Charlie, come here, Charlie. Oh, look at Charlie there. Hi, Charlie. Thanks.
All right, thanks for having us in your kitchen. You kind of know what the deal is. We're going to go into your fridge.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks for having us, man.
Yeah, of course. Thanks for coming. It's going
to
be fun.
Shane, always a pleasure to see you.
Right on. Thank you.
Here we go. What this sign says, just breathe.
It's not for me, by the
way. Oh, man, this is a nice fridge. Wow.
It's a lot of pressure when someone goes in your fridge.
It's like half vitamins. Yeah, it's like,
especially when Sam's going to your fridge.
I was going to say, well-renowned chef through your fridge.
I kind of like this lettuce that I'm seeing here. So this is good. We can make something nice with this. Very nice. You like that? Sweet. Cheese.
Good.
Don't forget the Skittles.
I like that. Where's the Skittles?
Skittles.
Jackson.
I like this. Mm-hmm. We're going to do something with this.
Okay.
Kathy's. Hi, Kathy's, yeah. Mm-hmm. Wow.
What
is this?
Yeah. Oh, this is good.
What about a sink?
So
although,
good.
I think it's about time to update the photo on the front.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. Well, maybe we can put some of this on the salad. And then you got game, right?
We do.
We'll talk a little bit about that.
Okay.
Oh, you got some nice vegetables, man. Look at this, asparagus, fresh carrots. Wow.
Yeah, we need some asparagus, that'd be good.
Cheese, we got that, put a little bit of this kind of cheese here. Yeah, I think we got a lot of good things here.
I don't know if we have enough pans for you.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, I shouldn't leave this up open too long, but I tell you what, I got the spinach in there. I want to just move on. I think I'm excited about the game, about a nice salad, nice vegetables. Right, Jackson?
Yep.
And we can't forget the mystery box. We call this bok choy. It's from our sponsors, Kraft and Heinz, and there may be something else in there. But Uncle Sam has to incorporate this into whatever we make.
I think there must be something good in there, because the dogs want it.
Okay, go ahead. I'll let you open it. There you go. Just lean it up against me.
Okay. We got...
Okay, Portuguese gravy.
Heinz ketchup.
Oh, wow, okay.
We got zesty Italian dressing.
Oh, that's going to be good with the game.
And buttermilk ranch dressing.
Also known as
white
gold. That's
going to be good with the game, too.
Yeah.
Cool.
Wow. Is that it?
That's it.
Oh, easy.
Got it?
I got it.
Say bye.
Bye.
I want Jackson. All you got to do is kind of like stir that without getting outside of the pan. Very good. We're going to turn the fire off. We're going to let that cool down, and then we're going to put it on the salad, okay?
Looks good, Jackson.
Yeah, you don't want to really crisp it up too much, because that's a turkey bacon, okay? You like it crispy?
I love it crispy.
Okay, so we're going to make it more crispy then. Lisa, do you have a bowl about this big, a stainless steel bowl? I want to show you guys a little trick.
Oh, yeah? So you said axis deer. So you hunted this on Lanai?
I did. I got that with my bow on Lanai. Yep.
Cool. I never knew why it's called axis deer, though. Why is that again?
I really don't know the origins of the name. I know that the deer were brought from India as a gift to the king of Hawaii.
Wow. Oh, really?
Yeah, in like the late 1800s.
Wow.
And they were introduced on Molokai first.
Molokai got lots, eh?
But yeah, there's so many deer here now, and they have no natural predators, so you're encouraged to get a lot of them with your bow, so that's what we try and do.
The meat has no fat on it. It actually looks like ahi slabs.
Yeah, it does.
There's no fat on it.
Yeah, so that's the main difference between wild game and domestic meat. The wild game doesn't have any fat on it at all, so you really have to, instead of like leaving the white part on the outside of the meat like you would, you have to trim all that stuff off
because there's no fat. Look at this.
Wow.
Yeah, look at
good
this.
Good job, Charlie.
Oh, perfect. Huh? Oh man, she's got it.
And now what about this one?
That one is elk, and it's from Utah.
How many pounds was that?
That elk was about 900 pounds.
From about how far away did you hit it?
I got him at about 42 yards.
Okay, put a little oil in a pan like this. Okay. I like to just do this to the pan, so like what you want to do is after you're done cooking with it, this is how you clean it.
Without washing, right?
Yeah, that's all. You don't wash it, just like that. So you take your Axis deer meat, throw it all in here, just like this. Look at this. You've done this before?
I have not. Not this way, and definitely not this hot.
Well, tell the folks at home how you would normally do it.
Normally, I would put it in a hot pan, not this hot. I'd put it on really quick and sear it, mm-hmm. and then I would take it off and turn the heat way down on the pan to a really low heat, and then I would cook it all the way through to where it's like a medium rare, but not raw in the middle. That's the key, is to not have it raw in the middle.
Yeah. You were saying, too, this kind of meat with no fat is real easy to mess up.
See? You see, it doesn't stick, see?
Right.
Oh.
That's what you want.
I'm assuming Uncle Sam knows a little bit about how to cook. So.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm excited, you know, because, you know, we always try and cook the wild game in different ways, but it's fun to have someone with a totally different perspective and tons of experience as well.
Well, the nice thing about this is local. And if you look at it, man, there's kind of like not a stitch of fat on it.
Yeah.
You know, look at this. Just beautiful.
That's really quick.
Yeah.
It's so quick.
I always like to use a fork.
Yep.
Yeah, because see, so all you're going to do is just hit a corner right here like that.
Yep.
I bet the only time you don't use it is with a toaster.
Yeah, you're right. You want to be careful, but you know what happens with a toaster, right?
Oh, yeah.
So you're just going to sear the outside like that?
Yeah, just like that. I'm just going to put that. And then you let it sit and rest. That is really the key to any kind of pan searing, is that you let it rest.
And is it resting in the pan, or are we gonna take it out of another pan?
Rest it in
a pan.
Wow. Okay. Or we can put it in another pan there and finish it in the oven.
It cooks so fast.
You know, so yeah, it does. You know.
Oh my gosh.
This right now, and another thing too, you press it, it's kind of like rare. It's like raw yet. It's still raw.
Yeah. You just put it on this for 20 seconds. Yeah. Brown.
Right. So I didn't add black pepper. You see that? That's right, these cast irons are made to do stuff like this.
I'd be so scared that I was overcooking it.
Well, you know, I mean, everybody, that's the number one challenge for all of us, right?
Well, because if you slightly overcook wild game, it gets really, really chewy, but then you also don't want any rawness on the
right.
Inside.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, so what's the biggest wave you caught so far? Don't tell me 8 feet.
8 feet?
Oh, man.
I got a really hollow 8 foot wave,
with some
I got
help
like a
from
9 foot mushy wave.
Really?
Super mushy.
That'd be really good.
Ooh, that one looks so good.
So you kind of like make a little room, right? On the side. Because what I want to do is I want to do like a couple nice pieces of the elk. So this was a 900 pound elk, man. This is amazing.
You can see the difference in the meat too.
Yeah.
I'm assuming that's not your first elk.
No, I've gotten 3 elk so far. Actually, that's not true. I've gotten 4 elk so far. 1 cow and 3 bulls.
Is it pretty a for sure thing when you go, you're going to get
No,
something?
No. So the place I got my first elk
in
Colorado, the success rate for archery is less than 7%.
Oh, man.
So out of 100 people, less than 7 people actually get an elk with their bow.
That would frustrate me to no end.
I'm fine with it, though.
It's the nature of the beast,
if
right?
If it frustrated me a lot, I'd be a gun hunter. Because you can shoot, you know, 400 yards, 500 yards, 800 yards, a lot of people. I love archery, I love bow hunting. I like the challenge, I like that it's quiet. And I also like that sometimes I come home with nothing. It's actually great, so.
Got milk but can't drink it? The American Journal of Nutrition says up to 90% of Asians are lactose intolerant, unable to digest the sugars in milk products.
Some people rely on kefir to lower that intolerance and feel good at the same time.
Kefir is a culture of bacteria and yeast that looks a lot like cottage cheese. I top off my colony with milk and let it sit overnight in a cool, dark place. The fermentation eats up the lactose. In the morning, I strain the grains from the liquid.
Well, I think it's important to do probiotics to feed the lower gut ecology. We don't know how much, but we do know that there's no harm and probably a lot of good. So having a kefir once a day, cultured yogurt with live bacteria, is beneficial.
Especially if you're lactose intolerant. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
And so that's very unseasoned as well, you know?
Yeah.
So how long do you let this sit?
Oh, maybe 10, 15 minutes.
Oh, that long.
I got the elk here.
Sam, you added some of the mushrooms like you said you would in the bottom of the pan.
I'm gonna cut some mushrooms right now, just quartering it. I think, you know, Shane and Lisa got some beautiful mushrooms here. Kids like mushrooms, right? You don't like mushrooms?
You should try it.
I like vegetables.
Okay, you're gonna love vegetables.
But you like salad?
Yeah, the only thing I like is salad. Ah. The only vegetables I like.
So you guys got soy sauce, right?
I love it a bunch.
So you got a little trick.
Yeah, I'll try one mushroom.
You might turn over a new leaf tonight. There you go.
That's the one you
want. That's my
right
star
there.
Right there.
You almost forget that it was that cute little Bambi hopping around and
John.
Hey, at least we know where it came
from. It's good.
From.
It's good.
You know what? That's
it's good to know
right.
where
know
it comes
where it came from. We know.
There's nothing wrong with it, you know? There's nothing wrong with the.
We know the butcher. We know the. Yeah. Everything.
And the cook.
And the chef. Yeah.
Yeah. That, I mean, that deer right there was cleaned in the field.
How big?
On the
how
grass.
Big of a deer was that?
In the, you know. It's cool though because I've learned to do it all myself. All of the field dressing. I put the neck into roasts and then I put the loin and the tenderloins and the steaks. And I cut everything for like dinner sized portions for the family. And then the rest, I have a grinder and a slicer. So we use it really often. We probably eat wild game like 3 or 4 days a week.
Wow. So this is the perfect right here. That's the perfect right here. You see that? That's the perfect. It's moist. It's not red.
That looks good. Yep. That right there with some Hawaiian salt.
Ooh. Yeah.
Sam, you cut the deer the same way as like after like in the sushi restaurant. I've seen like they've had a bunch of sashimi exactly like that.
Yeah, pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, so good.
Little furry fangs.
You hungry? Tummy hungry?
Yeah. Uh-huh, I want to eat your face right now.
This elk is sick. Man.
I think Charlie might need some salt on it.
Yeah.
It's really great with salt.
There you go. Okay, guys, this is the elk, man. Where's mom?
Oh, I'm here. I'm not missing out on this.
How's that?
Really great.
Oh, that's good.
So simple, y'all.
Yeah, see, that's the
that's the beauty
that's
of it.
That's the magic, yeah. Charlie. Here we go.
I like that olive oil theory. That is so good.
Huh? This will be a first for me.
Hey, Johnny. I got the rare. I love rare. Oh.
Oh, it's so good. You really can bite the difference. Yeah?
Mm-hmm. You can. The elk's a much more mature animal, too. The elk was probably about 7 or 8 years old. The axis deer would have been like 2 or 3 years old, probably.
Okay, guys. Little salt on the top.
I can take that if you like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So what we got in here is our love. I got a little butter. Oh man. I'm gonna turn the fire off. Grab our pan. It's hot.
Yeah.
So Jackson, always on a stove, you always grab a towel. Do this. Grab it under here like this.
I don't really want to be a bacon duty. And
we're gonna put all our mushrooms right on top of that. How's that, Shane? What do you think?
That looks amazing.
Yeah. And in that sauce, I just got the drippings from the pan that I deglazed because we fried everything in that, right? Or bronzed. And then I added a little aloe shoyu into that. And then I put a little butter to finish it and then. Just pour this love right on top of it.
Very cool. That looks good, huh, Jackson? My mouth's watering.
I know. See? Mine is too.
Lisa, Thank you guys for having us.
Oh, yes.
Thank you very much for coming.
Does that mean it's the favorite time of
yeah,
the show?
Yeah, it's the favorite time of the show.
Time to grind.
Time to grind. Oh, this mushroom is sick.
Oh, sorry. Are you going to eat the salad?
Yep.
We had a food shot.
And Jackson's bacon.
Jackson bacon, frozen.
All right, Uncle Sam, so we have to use those ingredients.
Right.
So what are you going to do?
Well, basically, we're going to go straight, you know, as is.
Right, you have two salad dressings and ketchup.
But then, you know, like Shane said, this is good as a dip for the game. So we're going to do this right here with this one right here.
Okay.
Yeah, that's okay.
Nice.
And then that's one. And then this one here. Shake it up good, which is our Kraft Zesty Italian. Okay, so then this is done, okay? Now this is what we're going to do. So we're going to put this right on my plate like this. Okay, Charlie?
Nice.
More. Good job.
So more, little more.
A little more, Charlie.
Okay, great. Now this one here will come out really quick.
And I'll do the ketchup.
No, you're going to be the stirrer.
Okay.
I think we're ready to jump
okay.
in.
Time to grind.
Yay.
Let's do this.
I'm going to give, you want some salad?
Yes, please.
Jackson.
Oh, so Shane, this year, biggest wave so far?
Biggest wave so far this year is probably about chest high.
Really?
2017.
Right.
So I got a better one for you. Biggest wave ever.
Biggest wave ever.
Paddling, 58 feet, right? Was it close?
Yeah, right about there. Paddling.
58 feet?
So 1 year, I got the Guinness Book of World Record for the biggest wave ever paddled. And I think that's what it was, about 58 feet.
Salad for you. 58 feet. What is that like?
Scary.
And where was that at?
That would it be at Jaws on Maui. Jackson, that piece of deer you have is really rare. Do you want me to find you a different one?
Let me ask you. Does it make you nervous?
Him.
To see him out?
Of course. Yeah.
Does it make you more nervous to know that this one?
Hey, this is really good, man.
Yeah. It's different when it's your husband and then when it's your son. I can't explain that either, but it is.
So while he's out there surfing, you got the kids, right?
Yeah, we stay home because he only goes for like a day or two. And it's just not good for him to not be focused 100% on what he's doing. So we stay home and he just calls as soon as he gets out of the water and
he's safe.
Yep.
Man, this axis deer, that dressing is really good on a dip.
Good.
Yeah, very good.
I would never thought mixing ketchup.
Neither would I.
That's good, huh?
So what are your plans for this year?
My plans for this year are more of the same. I mean, I'm chasing really big swells, doing some trips with some surfers I really want to travel with. I'm going to be traveling to Fiji and Tahiti and Bali.
Where's that place that got that real gnarly wave, like it doubles up?
Shipsterns?
Where?
Shipsterns or the right?
I don't know.
I love this.
I think he's talking about Portugal, Nazaré.
Oh, yeah.
The real giant wave that Garrett toes into?
Yeah. I see guys come into it, and then next thing you know, you see the bottom. The board just kind of
wipe out.
Float her up.
You said it. Worst wipeout.
He's got them.
I've had quite a few bad wipeouts. One of the worst ones I've ever had. Mm.
Was at Mavericks.
Just got held down a long time and pounded pretty good.
No way.
It happens. I didn't think I was going to make it for a little
bit.
But
a good thing did come out of that is he invented an inflatable vest.
You pull cord and they have these two oxygen tanks that will blow up in your suit and it'll fill up like this.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll come floating to the surface.
It's just an inflatable wetsuit.
There's a bunch of people that
I have a patent with Billabong.
Big waves, but ever since, not a single person been killed.
So Lisa, I mean, all the surf, but your thing, you have a little business too, right?
Mm-hmm. I do little girls' bikinis.
Yeah. Whoa, cool. What's your company called?
Kimi and Lee Bikini.
Can you tell them how they got
this is name? This is the best marketing person
in
Orange
County. Totally.
There could ever.
Yes. Kimi was my grandmother who gave me my first bikini, and Lee is short for Lisa. So it became Kimi and Lee.
Very nice. I just want to say thank you so much for, one, inviting us to your house. I love watching you skate. I love watching you shoot. And it's been great to be able to cook in your kitchen.
I really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. And I tell you what, maybe a little rare, but that's okay because you could finish it in the oven. About 10, 15 minutes at about a 300 degree oven after you sear it.
Well, while you remember that tip, also remember this.
When Sam Choi is in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Right, what? Buddy, right here.
We're cooking right now.
I really want something to eat.
You do that right there.
I do too, honey.
Wait, my turn.
Just kidding.